presidents have taken very divergent positions, and legitimately so, which in the face of it look to us as unreconcilable. They always told us one time when I was young, that when you come to the edge of the world we know as it is, and you reach the edge, and it's pitch darkness outside there, and you need to move forward, you have only, there's uncertainties and pitch darkness. You'll be forced to take a leap of faith. And when you take that leap of faith and you jump, they say two things happen. Either you find a firm ground upon which you put your feet on, or alternatively, you grow wings and you start to fly. Your Excellencies, as your Director General of Universal Postal Union, and my Deputy Director General and the entire IB management team, as responsible people, you have entrusted with the responsibility to maintain the integrity and the credibility of this union during the last two cycles. The confidence you have given us when you elected us here, the trust and respect you have given us to protect and withhold the dignity of this organization, it befell upon us as a responsibility to ensure that this organization remains together as one solid entity, despite our differences. I've said this many times, this organization has been challenged many, many, many times in the past 145 years. Your Excellencies, we have survived two world wars and many depressions and many challenges, particularly innovations and technologies that threaten the Union. But we have survived every time because men like yourselves and women like yourselves have sat down and changed the course of history of this organization. And today, as you sit here in this hall, that is the responsibility that's on your shoulders. Your Excellencies, when we have seen the divide between member countries, I took a leap of faith and called for an we took the decision to call for this extraordinary session of the Congress, which was welcome for us because I believe that a matter of this nature, of this sensitivity, to be decided in different parts of the world on a ballot was not the best way to deal with this subject. You took the right decision to hold for an extraordinary Congress, and we prepared for that, and that's why you're here today. And I want to thank you for that decision. Your Excellencies, when we saw the challenge, the leap of faith I took is to call for what is called the good office of the Director General Consultative Group. It's not that when we chose the 34 countries that came here on Sunday and Monday, it's not that the other member countries were not important, but we couldn't get one next two people in a small hotel called Warwick Hotel. So I had just to get a representative of the member countries, specifically those ones that were driving these options, and what is called the consultative group that was dealing with this subject in the past. We also were very careful, we selected from all the different regions so that the regional representation was taken into consideration. We are big countries, we are small countries, and of course, we went into action for 2 days. The whole of Sunday, we went late into the night, and on Monday, we worked very hard to drive a compromise position. I want to say that at the end of that exercise, we came very close to a proposition or a proposal which in our view, if we have reached, then we would not have had the necessity to hold this meeting. Would have come to you here, and by acclamation you would have given us your support, because we feel that all the interests of the member countries were taken into consideration. One of the paramount principles that we have adopted during that session is that whereas we may not be able to satisfy everybody's needs or every position held here, the needs of gospel, at least we didn't want people to go back from this session empty-handed or half of the world happy and the rest of half of the world disappointed. Therefore, in that spirit, we worked very hard, and really, what we knew or what we felt was that option C was where the solution was going to be. And we developed a proposal. We came this close to be able to reach that ultimate option we call the victory option. However, we were not able to achieve that, and therefore it became necessary for us to come here and seek the advice of this country. Yesterday, Excellencies, when I sat in this hall, and I was sitting in this very spot, and I looked at them, all of you here, and when option B was put into a vote, I was holding my breath. I was praying silently here. But if that option had gone through, I knew half of these member countries here would go back very disappointed. The wisdom of this council yesterday dictated that we had today an possibility to have a look at the option which we looked at. We could not come to a conclusion, but again, you gave us another opportunity for us to reflect on these things. And from last night, I can tell you, we have had a very long session. None of my member teams here have slept last night. Up to 2-3 in the morning, I think we were still awake trying to get the views of member countries, put them together, and work a compromise. So, Your Excellency, allow me to say that at the end of a very, very long night, it became necessary this morning when we came to the Bureau of Congress to request the chairman of the Congress to allow us at least 2 more hours. That is between 9 o'clock to 11 o'clock. But we realized that we still needed a lot of consultation to be done this morning to really close the gap between what we have found. So, in essence, what I can tell you, Your Excellencies, is that as I speak to you now, I am very motivated, I'm very hopeful that we may have achieved the victory that all of us has brought us together here, a victory which will not allow any one member of our member countries to leave our union, a victory where all the citizens of this parliament who are listening to us today, who are looking at this hall, who are looking at us for a decision to see how this union is going to go, the victory for all those citizens, we have it very close at hand. That's only if, and if this August Assembly here will be able to agree with what we have come up with. So, Mr. Chairman, without taking anything from option C, which you have, and the program, and the process that which is already there, which you can fall back on, I want to request you, all of you, to allow me to be able to present the views we have gathered this morning and the option or compromise which we have presented before you discuss this thing. You can always come back to this if you don't like the idea we are going to present. So, may I have, and I request you humbly, to give me permission to be able to do that. By acclamation, if possible. Thank you very much. Your Excellencies, I would now like to give the floor to the Deputy Director General, Mr. Pascal Kleber, a man I have a lot of respect for, a co-pilot, someone I have, and let me tell you this, I have to say this for the record. It was in Latin America, in Costa Rica, about 3-4 weeks ago, when we met there and we saw what was going on, that myself and the Deputy Director General sat one evening and said, look, our member countries have done the best they can. The calling is upon me and him to decide what we are going to do with this union and to start the process. So the process you see here today, actually, we took the decision to call for this meeting when we were in Costa Rica. And I gave him the responsibility and the mandate to all my secretariat team to come up with a different option, completely different from everything else that member countries have done, just in case they are not able to agree. And therefore, from that time onward, this man sitting on my right, I can tell you because the entire team have worked long and hard and they develop this process. So I want to give him the floor. Mr. Pascal Cleaver, co-pilot, please take the controls and deliver this new module to the member countries. Thank you very much.
Merci, Monsieur le Secrétaire Général. La dernière fois que je suis intervenu de la sorte, c'était au Congrès postal universel d'Istanbul. Ironie du sort, sous votre présidence, Monsieur Bozgeyik. L'histoire se répète donc, et après la réforme institutionnelle que nous avons vécue à Istanbul, l'objectif aujourd'hui, c'est celui de vivre la réforme des frais terminaux ou la réforme de la rémunération. Et donc je vais donc vous demander instamment, parce que c'est la condition de la réussite, de bien vouloir écouter cette proposition et de ne rien changer au contenu de cette proposition, car c'est encore une fois la synthèse des possibles. Si un élément, c'est pas une possibilité de faire du cherry picking, si un des éléments tombe, le risque est que tout tombe. Donc cette option V pour victoire, comme l'a nommé notre secrétaire général, est d'abord la vôtre, c'est pas celle du bureau international. Nous avons travaillé, comme l'a dit le secrétaire général, depuis 11 mois, jour, nuit, y compris la dernière, avec les esprits, avec les gens de bonne volonté, avec les techniciens, avec le bureau international. Je remercie tous les directeurs, en particulier Siva, qui est le directeur en charge, le directeur de la régulation des marchés, mais aussi mon ami le directeur Boussetta, le directeur des opérations Postal, le directeur du développement, M. Rudy Quadra, le directeur des affaires juridiques, car sans eux, on ne peut rien faire. À chaque fois qu'on change quelque chose, il faut s'assurer que toute la mécanique de l'avion fonctionne. Comme l'a dit le directeur général, notre objectif, c'est d'atterrir en sécurité. Cette fois, c'est à l'aéroport de Genève. Donc, on va essayer de le faire. Genève, on l'a dit, est un lieu qui inspire, parce que c'est le lieu aussi des synthèses. Et donc nous avons, tout au long de ces jours, nous sommes efforcés de rassembler, rassembler et encore rassembler. Et donc ce que nous voulons, c'est qu'une famille unie, qui devrait souffler le 9 octobre prochain les 145 bougies du bateau. L'UPU est un lieu des possibles, car chacune et chacun, dans cette dernière phase, a fait preuve de grandeur. Tous et toutes ont fait preuve de grandeur, du sens des responsabilités. Alors on sait, ce n'est pas l'accord parfait, mais ça y ressemble. Donc en synthèse, comme l'a dit le secrétaire général, nous avons débuté par une consultation des 34 pays membres que nous avions estimé être celles et ceux les mieux placés pour travailler à cette synthèse. Nous avons utilisé les différents niveau de développement économique, nous avons utilisé les différents leaderships, nous avons utilisé celles et ceux qui pouvaient, à notre sens, le mieux travailler sur ces synthèses autour des trois options qui étaient l'option A, l'option B et l'option C. Donc nous avons demandé à ces gens d'avoir la gentillesse de nous rejoindre, c'était à l'hôtel Warwick, nous l'avons fait dimanche, et lundi matin. Nous avons, en marge de ça, entamé beaucoup de consultations avec un certain nombre d'entre vous. Ils se reconnaissent, ils sont dans cette salle, je les remercie. Chacune et chacun a eu la sagesse de la synthèse. Notre objectif, le seul et unique, était le maintien de l'intégrité de l'Union postale universelle. Il faut que ces choses se discutent au sein de l'Union postale universelle. Ce n'est pas des dossiers qui se discutent multilatéralement. Seul le multilatéralisme peut avoir une réponse à ce genre de problème. Donc nous avons pris un certain nombre d'initiatives. Nous avons travaillé d'abord avec une méthode, celle d'introduire des paramètres, non contentieux, pour nous assurer qu'au départ, et sur la base de l'option C, qui nous semblait être celle de la synthèse, de manière à ne pas et ne jamais réouvrir les points dans ces paramètres. Nous avons avancé ainsi, et comme l'a dit le secrétaire général, le dimanche et le lundi, Nous avions plutôt la mine grise, ce n'était pas tout à fait le résultat auquel nous nous attendions. Mais nous sommes rentrés dans cette salle aussi plein de confiance, car les 40 heures qui ont été dispensées durant cette réflexion ont été de toute façon utiles la nuit passée pour revenir là où les lieux du possible existaient. Donc nous avons aussi utilisé vos réflexions d'hier après-midi. Un certain nombre de choses nous ont inspirés dans le cadre de la négociation. Et ce matin, le secrétaire général, l'équipe du Bureau international, à la demande d'un certain nombre de pays membres, ont souhaité que cette synthèse puisse se faire. Nous avons reconsulté ce matin sur les points de vue méthodologiques, les paramètres et autres. Et donc maintenant, et afin de ne pas commettre aucune faute technique durant cette présentation, j'ai demandé à mon ami Siva d'entamer avec vous chacun des points qui a été à la base de cette proposition V. Encore une fois, ce n'est pas la meilleure proposition possible, c'est celle qui somme tous les possibles. Nous avons travaillé de manière intégrée, nous avons voulu intégrer tous les paramètres possibles, et encore une fois, c'est une seule et unique proposition. Nous ne pouvons pas commencer à jouer sur les paramètres. Donc Siva, je te donne la parole pour la suite et la présentation technique. Merci.
Thank you very much, Deputy Secretary General. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. As the Deputy Secretary General has mentioned, what I will present over the next few minutes is what constitutes option B, which represents a compromise package that we've tried to build in terms of the various interests that member countries have.